What's going on, guys, and welcome back to more MLB The Show 20. So far, the series is tied to a game apiece. Today, we're playing Game 3 of the ALCS. And for today's matchup, we got Dallas Keuchel versus Zach Greinke. So, hope you guys enjoy, and if you do, hit that like button. And if you're new, please subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot for watching.
MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 3 of the AL Championship Series between the Chicago White Sox and the Houston Astros. Zach Greinke will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, we're taking a look at one of the top pitchers in the game. This guy has over 200 career victories, and he'd like to add another one to this list. This guy's been a really good pitcher for a long time, and right now, he's showing no signs of slowing down. It'll be interesting to watch him work in this one here.
Hit to short, reined in. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. Now a moment here to check out the White Sox starting lineup. Danny, any thoughts?
Well, Matt, the guy to watch has to be Jose Abreu. I mean, this guy is a career 300 hitter. You talk about consistent. He delivers a good at-bat and clutch hits basically every time he walks into the box. I love watching this guy.
Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada. Throw on to first is in time, and Greinke's got himself two outs. Digging in, Jose Abreu, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. Curveball close, but it's one and one. And set up behind the plate is Ricky Holiday, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
Yeah, Dan, we got Ricky Holiday behind the dish tonight. I can't figure his zone out. He doesn't favor the hitter or the pitcher and can be a little too inconsistent at times.
D-Row, you hit the nail right on the head. I think one of the things we're looking for a consistent zone. If it's a tight zone, it's a high zone, have the same zone. His zone fluctuates a little bit too much for my liking during the course of a game.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Down in order go the Dallas Keuchel gets the ball in Game 3 of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, every team needs a pitcher like this one here. His numbers aren't going to blow you away. Career ERA just under 4. But one thing he does, he takes the ball every 5 days, throws strikes, and gives his team a chance to win every single time he goes out there. He'll be fun to watch in this one here today.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Popped him up. In comes Mazzara. He makes the catch, a great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Batting second. No left field.
Time now for a quick look at the hometown Astros starting lineup. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Well, I'm watching the guy they call Dr. Smooth, Michael Brantley. He's coming off a multi-home run game. And when you start hitting two home runs or more in a game, that means you are swinging the bat pretty darn good.
And this will kick off the base of the wall. And he's not stopping. He wants three. And he's out at third. Might have gotten a little greedy that time.
Oh, you hate to see guys run into outs, especially when it's because of an unnecessary risk. He had two all the way, and he clearly should have just been happy with that.
Here comes the first pitch.
That's a great pitch for a spot like that. It looks like a strike, then it just comes in out of the zone. If you can command that with movement, it's a very effective pitch for pitching hitters inside.
It's one and two. Two out, nobody on. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. Still one and two.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. And here's the switch hitting catcher, Yasmani Grandal. He'll lead it off against Zach Greinke to open up the inning. And the first pitch here is below the knees, but he gets him to chase it, and it's 0-1.
Now that's when you know it's a good pitch. He broke off a really nice breaking ball down in the zone right there, and even though this is one of the best hitters around, he waved right through it.
Behind 0-2 now. One and two to the White Sox catcher.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
And it's fouled away. Again, a 1-2. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. Into the box, Eloy Jimenez. He'll get to take his first cuts here. As a look, now the pitch. No balls and a strike to count. From the belt, kicks and deals. Now a drive out to left center field. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning.
Yeah, some guys have the ability to rise the occasion while some guys shrink away when it matters the most. Well, this guy is a gamer. He's been on fire since the postseason started, and after that hit, it looks like he doesn't plan on stopping anytime soon.
The 1-0. Fly ball out to straightaway center. Springer is there, and that should be deep enough to score the run. And a surprising decision there as he holds on at third base. Standing in now with runners in scoring position, Luis Robert. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. First pitch on its way. A shot down the first baseline. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. But the feed to the second baseman is a wide one. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
He's got a chance to add to this early lead as he'll bat with a couple of guys in scoring position. Now the 1-0. High in the air out to center field. Springer has a read on it. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. The relay, and he is in there.
Always productive to score runs when you can, and that sacrifice fly right there drives home the second run of the inning.
At the plate, Nick Madrigal. Here's the first pitch now from Greinke. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Fastball well outside.
Two balls, no strike.
Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots. And now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Tim Anderson.
And the next to bat will be Tim Anderson. And we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home so far this inning. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Here's a fly ball. Well hit. On the move is Reddick. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side.
Way to go. Astros.
First pitch of the at-bat. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Slider, and he can't pull the trigger. Two strikes. Liner toward right center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
A nice leadoff single to start the second right there. They're already down. They got to find a way to stay on the attack and get back in this game. We'll see how they play it here.
First delivery to him on the way. Alex Bregman is the batter now as he looks at a ball of 1-0. From the belt, kicks and deals. Swung on and missed, 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Ready with two balls and a strike. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. To second for one to Abreu for the big double play.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
George Springer is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike.
Hey, there aren't too many power hitters in the game that would let that pitch go by.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. High in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Keuchel into his motion, looking for the strikeout here on 0-2. And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball. Bases are empty here with two men out. And this is popped foul, but perhaps playable behind first. And no one can get there. We'll try it again. And another foul ball. Now another 1-2. Line drive, and that's a base hit in the center field. So good work on a 1-2 count to get on base.
It's the best competition in all of sport, the pitcher against the batter right there. He fouled off multiple pitches, refused to go down. Not only did he get a knock, but he ran some pitch total up too.
Springer is off of first with two away. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. Head-to-head passed with Dallas Keuchel. He's got one hit in 18. Now here's a ball hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Gone! A two-run home run here for Josh Reddick. His first homer here in the series as the Astros have bounced back to tie this one at two.
When this one left the bat, I thought it was going to be an easy out to right. But it just kept carrying and carrying. And the right fielder gave it a great effort and almost brought it back. But no dice.
Yuli Gurriel is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Back up the middle. And that's through for a hit. So that keeps the bottom of the second going.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Martin Maldonado is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. From the stretch.
He's gone back-to-back with off-speed stuff to start this AB, and neither has found the zone. He's trying to pitch him backwards, but that only works if...
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Astros play two on the two-run home run. We've played two, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece.
Leading off for the White Sox, the third baseman, Yoan.
Here's the first pitch now from Greinke. Pulled toward right center field. On the move is Springer. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Standing in, Jose Abreu, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Here comes the first pitch. And he lays off there, 1-0.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Ground ball left side. Defense set up perfectly. Throw on to first, two gone.
Now
And with two away now, let's give you a look at what's happening in the National League Championship Series, as they've got a good one brewing over there as well. First pitch on its way. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
He's attacking this hitter a lot more aggressively than he did the first time when he faced him and issued a walk. Coming right after him here.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. Home half of the third coming up. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Way to go for the Astros.
Here comes the first pitch.
Okay. Altuve.
A one pitch on its way. Hot shot to third. A dive. He's got it. He is out. And what a vital play there, preventing the leadoff man from getting aboard.
Great reactions on that one, and a good job to get down on the ground in time to smother it. Still had to get up and make the throw, and of course, he did that too.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Michael Brantley is at the plate now as he looks at strike one. The windup and the 0-1. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two.
You got to go into battle mode after falling down 0-2 and find a way to work yourself back to even.
Too low with a fastball there. One ball, two strikes. Swing and he pops him up. Moncada onto the grass, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
Hey, this guy's having a big series in the postseason. It looks like to me that the moment isn't too big for him. He's slowing the game down. He looks terrific.
Yeah, absolutely. Postseason monster right here, having a huge series. Any big leader can have their moment mid-May, but to do it when it gets cold outside means everything.
So far in this game, he's the only guy in the lineup that's gone down on strikes.
This is the only guy in the lineup that struck out so far, and now he finds himself in the hole with two strikes.
Tried to stay back on the changeup there, but this is chopped foul at home plate. And here's a fastball on 0-2, but it misses. 1-2 now. Runner at first here with one away in a 2-2 ball game. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
And that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Well, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, D-Ro. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit.
Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
Fly ball out to straightaway right field. Mazzara is under it, and the inning is over.
All set for the start of the fourth.
And up next, the exciting Eloy Jimenez.
First offering on its way. Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. Right side, hit hard. And he'll flip this on to Greinke, covering for the out.
Now batting.
So the bases are empty with one man gone.
And that'll bring up the power bat of Edwin Encarnacion.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Oh, he took a big swing at that one as this is driven out to deep left center field. And this one is gone. A home run. So a solo home run for Edwin Encarnacion. His second home run of the series, and it's given the White Sox a 3-2 lead.
Hey, that's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Stepping in now, Luis Robert. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. One for one as he reached base with a double his first time up. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Count is 1-2 now. Now here's the pitch. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. The 1-2 is laid off for ball two. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. So there are two gone now in the White Sox fourth. And that brings up the versatile Nomar Mazara. Hit hard on the ground to the right. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. But for the Sox, a run here in the inning on the solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 3-2 Southsiders. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros offense with Houston's manager, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
All right, Heidi, thank you. George Springer is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for the first out.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Hits this one hard the other way. Moncada fields it cleanly. Throw on to first will get him. Score it 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now.
Really up here.
Fouled off. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. We're in the fourth. 3-2 is our score. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Astros. Still a three. Settling in now, Nick Madrigal. He drew a walk his first time up.
The second baseman, Nick Madrigal.
Pitch on the way. Here's Greinke back to work now as he jumps ahead of the first man to greet him. It's strike one.
And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. That misses 1-2. Good job going down and hanging with it that time.
As a pitcher right there, do not be surprised if he throws the same exact pitch. He was lucky to foul that one off.
Bregman has it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now back.
Striding into the box, Tim Anderson. He flew out in his last at bat. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at bat. It's ball one. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
Outside, 3-0 now. Three runs, three hits, and no errors so far for the White Sox. High in the air out to center field. Springer giving chase. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. So here's Yoan Moncada. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Way late on the fastball for strike one.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. One and two now.
Count is 1-2.
Now here it comes. Line hard toward right center. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Their one pitcher is absolutely dealing right now. So this is a big moment in this game. If his teammates can pick him up and drive him in now, that might be all they need to get the W here.
Reddick will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Martin Maldonado. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Hit the other way out toward right field. Mazar is under it. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now back.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Jose Altuve. Now a swing and a fly ball. But no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Another one sent foul. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Soft liner towards short. And the throw here is going to get him at first. Excellent range there at short, and there are two away now. Now at the plate, Michael Brantley. Two hits in two trips for him thus far. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Keiko gets the sign. Here it is on 0-1. Two runs, seven hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side.
Hey, D-Roll, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the two-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into their pen as quick as possible. And if two-out knocks are the answer, then so be it. This is where you got to take stock in the situation. Adjust your batting gloves and realize you need a gapper to score this guy from first. If nothing less, pass the baton to the guy behind you and keep the line moving.
To 1-2 now. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. One left for you. Digging in the switch hitter, Yasmani Grandal. He's set to lead us off in the sixth inning. First offering on its way.
That's a ball. Count 1-0.
The 1-0.
Well, this is a spot you'd like to be in. 2-0, good hitter. He's going to turn it loose right here.
And this is a called strike at the letters. Looked like ball three, but make it 2-1 instead. Ball even at 2-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. To the right into the loaded up infield. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
Now back.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Eloy Jimenez. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at bat. It's ball one. A ball and a strike. Can't catch the corner away with the fastball. It's 2-1. One out, nobody on. Now a ball crushed high in the air, deep to left, way back there, and that one is long gone. It's a solo home run for Eloy Jimenez. His first homer so far in the series, and it's given the White Sox a 4-2 lead.
I can tell you one thing. You might get away with throwing a ball in that location in the minor leagues, but when you get one up like that in the zone right over the plate against these guys, you're going to get exactly what he got, a really bad result.
Now here comes the Houston manager out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a change here, as that's going to be all tonight for Zach Greinke. Gone after 5 1/3 here, as he never really found his groove in this one. Ryan Abreu, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here.
Number 66, Ryan Abreu. Now batting, the designated hitter. Edwin Encarnacion
now. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. And 0-2 count to Edwin Encarnacion. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen, as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. Bases are empty, one man out. And he looks at a ball, 1-2.
And that's his strikeout pitch right there. You know, you'll see a lot of guys swing right over the top of that one. But in this situation, he was able to hold back. That's a nice take.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
That's a pretty impressive pitch from a young arm like that. If you could spot your pitches there in advantage counts like 1-2, you're going to have a lot of strikeouts and soft contact.
First pitch on its way. Luis Robert stands in for the third time now, as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. Two out, nobody on. Hit the other way out toward right field. Reddick has a read on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. But for the Sox, a run here in the inning on the solo home run. Bottom of the sixth coming up. It's now a 4-2. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and stepping up is the shortstop, Carlos Correa.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
A high fastball is in there. Swing and a liner. Foul. The 1-2. Sent on the ground out to second. And that's out number one. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Now he'll step off and rethink this. Outfield shaded a bit to left center, the first pitch. Set to deliver the 0-1. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's his windup. I don't know if it's just flat stuff. But he's getting a lot of swings outside the zone, and he's having a big game.
The 1-2. Sharp ground ball toward the hole. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And the recovery's too late as he's able to beat the throw to first.
Jeez, this looked like a routine grounder that just got away from him. Every school kid knows that you've got to look it all the way into the glove. He didn't, and now they've got to deal with a one-out base runner.
George Springer comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Grounder down the line at third, but a foul ball, 1-1. A bouncer to the left side. And this is going to work out for him. It's an infield single to make it first and second now.
Now's a good time for your pitcher to take a deep breath. He still has the lead, although it probably doesn't feel like it. So he can't worry about how he got into this mess. He just has to figure out how to get out of this mess.
Josh Reddick
comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Hammers it to deep right field. Lazara's going back, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And a good throw is going to hold that runner at third, so they're loaded now with only one away.
Boy, D-Ro, that looked like extra bases right off the bat. This thing caroms off the ball.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. One run is scored. The run scores from second. It's a 4-4 game.
Hey, after being down by two, down, getting into the middle of this one, that's a huge base hit right there, D-Ro. Big two RBI knock.
Yeah, down by two right there, able to come through for the team, and we probably got an exciting finish on our hands.
Martin Maldonado is at the plate as he takes a called strike one.
It's really hard to match up this poor performance when you dive into the numbers. This guy's...
Oh, hang on now. This ball is crushed into left field, and this one ain't coming back. This ball is gone. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, his first homer here in the series, and it's now 7-4. Plate next will be Jose Altuve. He swings and grounds it to short. On to first, and there were two down. Now batting, Michael Brantley. He's got three hits, including a double to this point. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike.
When he's pitching effectively, usually that two-seam fastball is moving quite a bit, but here it's just kind of flat and straight. Could be a big part.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. But not before five crossed the plate, with the big blow being this three-run home run. 8-9 and top of the order. Ready for another chance? Nomar Mazara. He hit a sack fly earlier.
Nomar Mazara.
Here comes the first pitch. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. Into the Crawford boxes and gone. A solo home run for Nomar Mazara. His first homer so far in the series, and that lead is trimmed to 7-5 here. Stavinsky comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number seven. To the plate now, Nick Madrigal. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. Stavinsky typically throws a lot of strikes coming in out of the bullpen, resulting in low walk totals, although he has been snake bitten by the home run ball at times in the past.
One of the keys for this guy, Matt, is not being afraid to attack the strike zone. With that said, he is prone to giving up the home runs. I think one of the causes of that, Matty B, he leaves a lot of pitches up in the strike zone. He needs to be down in the zone when he's effective.
One ball and two strikes to count. To the left side, but it's well fouled. Great changeup there in the dirt for the third strike. And the throw is there to record the first out.
Well, you know you made a real nice pitch when you bounce it in the dirt and you still get the hitter to swing at it. That tells me that there's a lot of deception in that pitch right now.
First delivery to him on the way. Tim Anderson is at the plate as he looks at ball one. One out, nobody on. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Reddick has a read on it. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. So two away here is the Sox bat in the seventh, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The wind up and the 0-1.
Ball one. Ball one three. That's ball two. I got to count 2-2. Okay.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Popped him up. And it'll wind up hanging just long enough for him to run it down. And with that, the side is retired. Sox get one right back here on the solo home run. Bottom of the... Into the box now, Yordan Alvarez. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Aaron Bummer comes on to pitch from bullpen now in an unexpected move. He's their closer, so it's a surprise to see him here in the seventh. First pitch of the at-bat. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one.
You like the modern style of baseball. Here it is. Both starters kept their teams in the game. It's close right now. Now we hand it over to the nasty bullpens. Let's see what matchups are going to take place.
And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. That one bends into the zone. A strike on the breaking ball.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. High chopper to third. Moncada has it. And there's one away. So here's the Astros cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Correa, left field and carrying well. Looking up is Jimenez. Gone! It's a solo shot here for Carlos Correa. His first homer here in the series as they open up an 8-5 lead. That'll bring up the former first-rounder Alex Bregman. This will go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The next 0-2. And he fouls this one off. Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled away. Stays alive, still 0-2.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Swung on and chopped up the middle, fielded cleanly, and he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. George Springer the next to hit. First pitch coming, here it is. Pitch to the plate is a sinker for a called strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Lays off the sinker here, a ball and a strike. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Now here it comes.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. On his way to second is Springer. And he is in the second with a double, his third hit of the night. Josh Reddick. We'll dig in again, and as he does, we'll flash you back to inning number two as you get a look at his two-run homer that was a big blow early on. Here comes the first pitch. And this misses outside and a bit high. One ball, no strikes. Two out here and a runner at second. And it's fouled away. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Weakly hit towards first. Right to him. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One more for the... Ryan Pressly has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. So here's Jose Abreu. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. First pitch on its way. Now the 0-1. Pitch is popped up. Gurriel is there for it. And that's the first out of the inning. Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal. 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Swing hard liner to left center. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit.
Love the ability to push that ball the other way right there. Nice knock to the opposite field. That's a switch hitter's delight, the ability to use all parts.
And now Eloy Jimenez, as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. So far, 2 for 3 in this one. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. The 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Edwin Encarnacion stands in as he looks at ball one here. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. Great curveball there. Really fooled him with that one. And this is a ball to Encarnacion. 2-1 now.
Hey, curveball that kind of backed up on him right there. Might have popped out of his hand just a little bit earlier than he intended.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Count even at 2-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Here comes the payoff pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. A man left for the White Sox. Still looking up in it. Digging in now, Yuli Gurriel. He's 2 for 3 and looking for more here. Steve Cishek is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th. Taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. Cishek was known as a short relief specialist, a guy who came in, got one or two big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The 2-2 one more time. This is flared out towards second. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
Now that.
So coming to the plate, Martin Maldonado is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And that misses ball one. One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss for strike one. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Fouled off. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Moncada gloves it. In time to first, and there are two away. Coming to the plate now, Jose Altuve. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Two out, nobody on. Chopped to third. Moncada fields it cleanly. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Roberto Ozuna comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the 9th. New inning set to get underway. And next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Luis Robert.
They look like they're up against it here, down 3 on the road, trying to come back against the closer. Probably a design take right there. They need base runners, so they're going to make them try to bring the ball in the strike zone.
Popped up. Gurriel in foul ground, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
In now the power hitting outfielder Nomar Mazara. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Brantley is there, and there are two men gone now. Stepping in, Nick Madrigal. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. And he misses inside with that one. Ball one. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
Wow, that pitch wasn't even close, and he almost chased it. If I'm the pitcher, I'm going to expand the zone even more on the next one.
And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
It's always nice to give your fans at home something to cheer about, and they definitely did that right here, coming through with a big win at home.
No better time of year to come up big for your team than in the postseason, and that's exactly what this man did. He's our Topps player of the game.
And obviously, every game is so important in the postseason. So when you come to play like he did and make a big difference for your team, it's something that won't be forgotten.
8-5 tonight. The Houston Astros have taken a 2-1 series lead. Brian Abreu gets the W on the mound. Dallas Keuchel struggled and gets the loss after giving up 6 earned. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
3 hours and 43 minutes.